Hey, friends.
So last week I went to a Bernie Sanders rally on a Monday night, and it was amazing. And I don't want to get into any political debates, whether you disagree or you agree or like any fighting. I prefer none of that to happen, but I am a Bernie supporter, and I went to go see him when he was here in New York, and I took a bunch of footage from it. The problem was, I didn't charge my camera battery while or before I went, so my camera died like halfway through it. So there were times where I tried to turn that off and use my cell phone, but my cell phone video quality is not nearly as good as my camera quality. So some of the quality and sound is going to be probably below par, and other clips is going to be great. It's going to be HD and everything. So I just wanted to let you know before you watch this, and it was really great, and I'm feeling the burn, and I'm hoping that he gets the nomination. We'll see. We'll see what happens. So thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoy what I have. It was a really incredible time to be surrounded by so many people who all want the same thing. It was a really cool experience for me, so I hope you enjoy it.
Very nice to see in this city. It's a beautiful, beautiful thing. Very, very pleased to be here. Very pleased to be here for this man, for everyone here, for ourselves. We should just take it up. We should keep taking it up.
Leaders in clean energy, and he will create jobs and grow the economy while doing it. People say this is impossible. Lobbyists say this is impossible.
Lobbyists are wrong.
Lobbyists are dumb.
I love it in New York. New York for Bernie! I'd like to introduce an incredible actor, an incredible activist, an incredible human being, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Danny Glover!
people lived in Georgia. Segregation. I would experience laws that would, the laws that would mean that I would have to drink at a separate water fountain. I would have to use a separate toilet. I would have to use a separate door and all those kind of things in there. Those things have impacted me. It impacted me when I started to think about what role do I play as a citizen? And what do I really play? What role do I play in terms of social justice? When I saw Bernie Sanders being arrested, footage of him, photographs him being arrested, protesting for justice. That this wasn't just an ordinary candidate, someone who would take on this mantle of justice at some point in time, just in the near future, but he'd been here all through his particular life. And that's what he is. That's what Bernie Sanders represents.
We were 70 points behind Secretary Clinton. Today, in some national polls, we are winning. Yeah! Last week, Goldman Sachs reached an agreement with the federal government for a settlement of $5 billion. Other banks reach larger settlements. They reached these settlements because they acknowledge that they were selling worthless packages of subprime mortgage loans.
Hillary's worthless!
Now think about this for a moment. Think about this for a moment. The most powerful people in America running the largest financial institutions in this country have acknowledged that their business model is fraud. Now, on top of that, as all of you know, against my vote, Congress bailed them out because they were too big to fail. Well, it turns out that three out of the four largest banks today are bigger than they were when we bailed them out because they were too big to fail. It also turns out, we learned this last week, that five of them could not effectively complete what we call a living will, the means by which they would downsize if they faced a financial crisis. It seems to me, on top of all of that, that there is something really weird that if a kid gets picked up in New York City today with marijuana, that kid gets a criminal record that stays with him his entire life. Boo! But if you are a Wall Street executive that pays a $5 billion fine for illegal activity, you don't get a criminal record, you get a salary increase. That is what a rigged economy is about. It's what a broken criminal justice system is about. We're gonna bring justice back to that broken criminal system. Today we have a corrupt campaign finance system that is undermining American democracy. Let us be clear. Democracy is not a radical concept. It means one person, one vote. Democracy is not about super PACs and Wall Street and billionaires making large campaign contributions. That is not democracy, that is oligarchy, and together we will turn that around. And we said, if you want a candidate who is going to stand with you, who is prepared to take on the big money interests, we need your help. And in the last 11 months, unbelievably, we have received over 7 million individual campaigns. Unbelievable. And what that is about is saying that we can run a winning national campaign without being dependent on the big money interests. And Wall Street and all the media people, they say, well, Bernie, you know, you're like Santa Claus, you're giving away free stuff. Free public tuition, colleges and universities, lowering student debt. How are you going to pay for it? Well, I will tell you exactly how we're going to pay for it.
You!
8 years ago, the Congress bailed out the illegal behavior on Wall Street. I believe that now we should impose a tax on Wall Street speculation. Wall Street, now it is Wall Street's time to help the working families of this country. On 79 cents on the dollar compared to what men earn. The women in this country want the whole damn dollar. But a great nation is not judged by the number of billionaires or nuclear weapons that it has. A great nation is judged by how it treats the weakest and most vulnerable amongst us. Today, in my state, in your state, all across this country, there are millions of seniors, disabled veterans, and people with disabilities who are trying to get by on $11,000 or $12,000 a year Social Security. And you know what? Nobody can get by on $11,000 or $12,000 a year. Now, my Republican colleagues in the Senate, they got a brilliant idea. They want to cut Social Security. Bad news for them. We're not going to cut Social Security. We're going to expand Social Security. That is what this campaign is about. It is much more than just electing a president. It is empowering our entire people. Very powerful people when you choose to exercise that power. It is an enormously important primary because there are a lot of delegates at stake. My experience has been in this campaign so far is that we win when the turnout is high, we lose when the turnout is low. Tomorrow, let us all do everything we can to make sure that New York State has the largest turnout in a Democratic primary in its history.